The using the selection tool. Selection tool is great just because here, let's click on it. There we go. It's great because it can select areas, you can join areas together. There's multiple things you can do. So let's talk about just one shape. So if I do that shape and I just put a box around this, okay, I can move it wherever I want. Now, I could also just click on. And what I'm doing now is holding the shift button down, shift, and then clicking on it with the direct selection tool selected. And I can actually now click specific areas. So I can click all around there, and then I could delete, and oops, I missed one. And I could delete, backspace, delete, hit the button, and it's good to go. So when this is has that little gradient fuzziness, that little cross hatching that's on there, that means it's highlighted. So I can do the same with here, and with the selection tool, I can just select certain areas and move them. And you can kind of get, you don't have to do this, but it is it could be interesting as far as getting a little fancy with it. So I can select them also, delete and get rid of them. So I can grab it, and if it's one solid, I didn't put a square around. I just clicked on it and go. So if it's a solid like this, one piece, I can move around there and get what I want. So that's pretty simple with it. You can kind of do that almost with anything. If I just want to move areas, if I want the whole thing or half of it, just get rid of it. So if you want to erase things, now also. And you'll get to know this. This is a line tool, but at the same time, I grab the end here. I can move it around. So I'm hitting certain points where I can move it now. If I click on there, let's see if I can do it. Oh, no. And of course, now I say I don't want to do it, but I can't. There we go. I can grab certain points and kind of move it. So now I can shape it to a degree that I want. So if I go here. And this is something to get used to going through. I have the selection tool. Let's see here. If I do that, I can move that guy around. So I can kind of move it and create my own lines going through, which is neat. Okay. Oops. Now I'm starting to mess with everything else. So now you're getting this whole funkiness. So definitely, this is where when we get into layers, layers, we'll separate these because once again, it's. It'll cause maybe some issues when it comes to grabbing things you don't want to going through it. So, oops, nope. Here we go. So I can grab this and let's see if I can swing that down. See if I can, oh, no. See if I can connect it. Let's see if I can bulge this guy out a little bit. Yeah, spin around here like this. And this isn't really a huge deal. Like I said, there's that. Let's see if we can color something in yellow. And there you go. So you can really make some nice art with it. I'm going to do the selection tool. Get rid of that guy. Oh, but it also gets rid of this. So I can do the paint bucket and fill it in, that little area. So you fill in a lot of little areas there also. You get to figure that out. So that is the selection tool. Just helps you to move things around, objects. You move the whole thing if you want as one. Or you can do little pieces of it or take out little pieces that you want. Okay. So we can give it all this blue guy and then we're back to this. Okay. That is all.